Yes, hi guys. Let me continue from this. This question is third question we got given. In question number third, we have to prove here that ux square plus uy square plus uz square equal to twice of x ux plus y uy plus z uz. Okay, what is uz here? That partial differentiation here. So partial differentiation of u with respect to x whole square. This is partial differentiation of y, that means del u del y whole square. This is del u del z whole square equal to twice x into del u del x, y into del u del y plus z into del u del z. This we have to prove. Okay, what is given to us? This, if x square upon a square plus u plus y square upon b square plus u and z square upon c square plus u equal to 1, then we have to prove this. Okay, now let me prove this here. Differentiating first, okay, let me differentiate first. Differentiating first on both sides, or on both sides with respect to x. First with respect to x, because we have to find out here u is a function of x, y, and z. For z, up to z is given. So u is a function of x, y, z. Obvious. But we have to find out u, ux, uy, uz. Okay. So here, u is a function of, this is understood. Okay. So u is a function of x, y, z. We have to differentiate both these sides with respect to x first. That means, first this differentiation, let me take this by quotient rule. What is quotient rule here? Quotient rule is denominator as it is, that means a square plus u as it is, differentiation of x square, that means twice x minus sign. Now x square as it is, differentiation of this a square constant 0, u is del u upon del x or ux, let me write here del u upon del x, divided by a square plus u whole square. This is of this one. Now here we have only this b square plus u, which is a function of x, u is a function of x, it will be differentiated. If I differentiate it with the help of, I mean, quotient rule, let me take y square as a constant here. If I take b square plus u in the numerator, it will give us, let me write here, this is okay, let me take plus sign, right, as it is, del u del x of y square into b square plus u whole power minus 1. This we have to differentiate, first one. Similarly, second one, del of del x, okay, of z square within bracket, this is c square plus u whole power minus 1. I have taken that in there. Numerator. Okay. This is equal to 0 while differentiation of 1 is 0. So let me differentiate these two. What do we get from this one? From this we get this 1 is cancelled out. It will give us twice x upon a square plus u only. For the whole square, and this, if I divide this separately, this is x square upon a square plus u whole square. This is into del u upon del x. Only this step is multiplied by del u upon del x. Now in this case, let me, y square is constant. Because only this b square plus u will be differentiated. What is differential of this bracket minus 1 power? That will come minus sign first. Y square as it is. And differentiation of this will be b square plus u whole power minus 2, because minus 1 we have taken first. This is minus 2 power minus 1 minus 1. Okay, so power is minus 2. But now this brackets value is differentiated. B square is 0, u is del u upon del y, but del u upon del x. But x, u is different with respect to x, u. So this is del u upon del x. Del u upon del x. Similarly, this question, this is also minus sign. z square into c square plus u whole power minus 2 into del u upon del x. Region only u is differentiated. C square is 0, u will be differentiated. It will be del u upon del x. Okay. First, the bracket c square plus u whole power minus 1 minus the power will come before this minus sign. Z square is constant as it is. Now c square plus u will be differentiated, but before that the power will be lessened by minus 1. It will be minus 1 minus 1, that is minus 2 power. Again, c square plus u is differentiated, c square is 0, u is derivative from that x. Okay, equal to 0. This 1 is 0. Now let me further solve it. So what do we get? This is twice x upon a square plus u minus sin x square upon a square plus u whole square. Here del u upon del x, del u upon del x, del u upon del x. These three steps are there. So let me take common from them. What do we get? This is plus minus sign are taken from all the three common. This will be plus sign y square upon this. This is y square upon v square plus u whole square. This is z square upon c square plus u whole square. Okay, into del u upon del x, which is common, equal to 0. In these three, del u upon del x is common. But we have to find out del u upon del x. So del u upon del x, therefore, del u upon del x will be equal to this twice x upon a square plus u divided by whole these three values. If I write them as sigma sine this, this is sigma sine, let me write here, x square upon a square plus u whole square. Otherwise, this whole value is complete value, x square upon a square plus u whole square plus this y square upon v square. I have written there sigma sine. That means sum of all these, which is understood here. Okay. Or I can explain this, I can write this whole, that doesn't matter. That means, if I write this whole, let me write for just layman's language. Let me write this completely. This is x square upon a square plus u whole square plus sin. This is y square upon v square plus u whole square plus z square upon c square plus u whole square. This whole value is given. Okay. Now, second thing is whole square of this, because we have to find out ux square. That means, yeah, let me write here, ux whole square. That means, del u upon del x whole square. That means, whole square of this whole, that will be 4f square, whole square of this, divided by a square plus u whole square, division of this whole, and whole square of this whole. So I have just put a square here. This is f square b upon a square plus u whole square plus y square upon b square plus u whole square plus z square upon c square plus u whole square whole square. Okay, so similarly we will get u y square, u z square, del u upon del y from this equation. So this is u y square. Similarly, we will obtain what? But similarly, I can write, or we can go step by step. Similarly, del u upon del y whole square, or this is u y square, the second step, will be obtained as 4 y square. Similar with this b square plus u whole square divided by this whole value. So if I write it as sigma x square, same value will be obtained, this sigma x square upon a square plus u whole square of this. Okay. And then u upon del z whole square is equal to z square divided by c square plus u whole square, okay, upon sigma sine x square upon a square plus u whole square of this whole. The same value, this one will be obtained here. Just to base this, okay, I have written here sigma sine denotes sum of all these, whole square. Now if I add them, because it's addition of all the three, so adding this, let me write here, this is equation number, this one, okay, let me take this as second, this is value upon delux, okay, this is, let me take second, this is third one, well, let me write as second equation, this is third equation, this is the fourth one, and this is the fifth one. Okay, so adding, now let me write here after addition. Adding, yeah, third, fourth, and fifth, third, whole square this. Third, fourth, and fifth. Adding third, fourth, and fifth. We get, what do we get? U as square plus u y square. Z square is equal to everything here will be 4 common. Okay, here it is 4 common. X square upon this A square plus U whole square will be obtained. If I take 4 common out of them whole, that will be X square upon A square plus U whole square. After whole square, this Y square upon A square plus U. This is v square. This is v square plus u whole square. This is z square upon c square plus u whole square. Divided by whole square of this whole will be, let me write, complete. X square upon a square plus u whole square plus y square upon v square plus u whole square. Plus z square upon c square plus u whole square. So one time this is cancelled out. That means 4 upon that value will be here. Okay, so this second equation, let me write here. This one, this is second equation. This I could keep. Okay, just similar. Same question here again, okay, because that will be repeated, that will be required in the right hand side. Let me, okay, after addition, what we get here, this is 4 upon, only 4 is obtained in the numerator. Here it is sum of this whole, that means, let me write complete, x square upon a square plus 2 whole square, y square upon a square plus u whole square, z square upon c, this is one, b square, c square plus u whole square. This only value we have obtained. Okay, this is whole square in the denominator as well as z square, x square in the numerator. Okay, so that is given to us. But in this case, in the first one case, in the denominator there is no whole square, but here we have one whole square. This is the difference in this case. Alright. Now let me take this question. This is the second question, value upon delux. Here, twice x upon this. Okay, if I multiply this by x, with twice x multiplication, for twice x is common. Okay, twice x. If I multiply this by twice x, this is ux here. Twice x, if I multiply this, will be 4x square only in the numerator. Multiplying the second equation by 4x, by sorry, twice x. What do we get? Multiplying the second equation, multiplying, this is the left hand side solution, I mean the value of left hand side we have obtained. This is LHS. left-hand side value, whether it of this is obtained. This whole value is equal to this. If we prove that right-hand side is also equal to this, then we can say that left-hand side is right-hand side. Okay, so this left-hand side we have taken. Now, for right-hand side, let me take multiplying this second equation. Multiplying second y twice x, we get. What do we get here? Is it twice x into del u upon del x? Twice x into ux or del u upon del x? Is equal to this 2 multiplied by twice x numerator. Only 4x squared upon a squared plus u on del x. In the denominator, we will get this whole square. This is sigma sine x squared upon del u in brief. In the finally, I'll write it as whole square. This is sigma sine x square upon a square plus b whole square. Okay, this is a bit different from the first equation. Similarly, we will get, similarly, we get twice y into del u upon del y is equal to 4y square upon b square plus u, which divided by sigma sine. Again, in the denominator, you will get this whole value. This will be x square upon b square plus u, or this is b square, x square plus u whole square. The same value, the sum of all the three, x square upon a square plus u whole square, plus y square upon b square plus u whole square, plus z square upon c square plus u whole square, the same value, sum of these will be obtained in the denominator. And let me write here, and twice z, del u upon del z, will be, this is twice y, del u upon del x, twice x, del u upon del y, 4 times x square, 4 times y square, this 4 times y square, and this will be 4 times z square. 4 times z square upon limit we will have c square plus u only. C square plus u. Here a square plus u. Here b square plus u. Here c square plus u. Divided by the same value, sigma sine. This is x square upon a square plus u whole square. This is whole square. This is we will obtain the denominator of these three similar. So let me write it as 6 1 2, this is 6 1, by so this is 6, this is 7, and this is 8th equation. Now adding the 6th, 7th, and 8th, let's try to understand what do we get then? Adding 6th, 7th, and 8th. Now let me rub this. So we obtain here. Let me write here, adding 6th equation, 7th, and 8th, we get, if I take common, 2 common throughout, 2, and this twice that, so 2 common, it will be x into del u upon del x, plus y into del u upon del y, plus z into del u upon del z. Okay, this value. Sum of these three in the left hand side. In the right hand side, we obtain what? We obtain 4x square upon this is a square plus u. Okay, divided by sigma sine. This is x square upon a square plus u whole square plus sine. This is 4y square upon b square plus u divided by the same value. The denominator is same. F square sigma sine x square plus a square u whole square. This is plus 4z square divided by c square plus u division divided by sigma sine again x square upon a square plus u whole square. Let me write. Let me summarize this. We obtain what? We if I take common four from all these four, what do we obtain here? We obtain four technique, let's take common. Can we x square on a square plus, now denominator is same, LCM is same. This whole value will be added. This will be y square upon v square plus u plus z square upon c square plus u divided by, now this LCM let me write complete like this. It will be x square upon a square plus u whole square plus y square upon v square plus u whole square plus z square upon c square plus u whole square. Now, in this case, this is a whole square, not similar values. But in the numerator, what will we get? Similar as the equation 1. This whole value is equal to 1. We found first, this can be substituted as 1. Because the similar value is obtained as in the equation number 1. So from first, this is equal to 4 into 1 divided by this whole value. X square upon a square plus u whole square, y square upon v square plus u whole square, z square upon c square plus u whole square. Okay, this is nothing but 4 upon the same value, 4 upon this whole. This is sigma sign x square upon a square plus u whole square. I have written as sigma sign this one step. This is the addition of all this. Okay. A similar value is obtained. So this left hand side, this is right hand side. What do we see here? The left hand side is right hand side. This value, which is x, ux, which is y, uy, this is z, uz. Okay, this is in the right hand side. This twice x, ux plus y, uy plus z, uz, twice of this equal to. These two values are equal. So we see that the left hand side equal to this left hand side. Similar value is obtained here. This is denominator same. Okay, so these two are equal. Hence it is put. Left hand side equal to right hand side, we can say left hand side equal to right hand side. Hence it is put. So this we have to prove. Now let me take the next question. Now question number 4. Which have four, three parts. Let me take these three parts of question number 4. Question number 4 is, let me take. Question number 4 is, what does it say? It says that if u equal to log of e this, then prove that del u upon del x plus del u upon del y plus del u upon del z equal to 3 upon x plus y plus z. Okay, let me take fourth. Question number 4 says, if u is equal to log of e, this is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3 x y z. Okay, then to prove, this is given to us, this equation number 1. Given to us and to prove, first let me take A only, then B and C and so on. So let me take first A. We have to prove that del u, del x, del u, del y, del u, del z is equal to 3 upon x plus y plus z. Okay. This is your equation number. This we have to prove. Prove here this. Differentiate this first equation. With respect to first x, del u del x is to be obtained, del u upon del y, and del u upon del z. Let me differentiate. Differentiating equation number 1 with respect to x first, we get on both the sides. This is del u upon del x. In the left hand side, u is del u del x, partial differentiation. Keeping y and z constant first time, because this is the respect to x here. That here we can take keeping y and z constant. partial differentiation. So naturally, when we are differing with respect to x, keeping other variables constant. So that we treat as constant. Value analysis, first of all, log says that it is 1 upon x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xy z into differentiation of this whole. This is this will be, because we are differing with respect to x, only x terms which are including x, that will be differentiated. This first is x cube, that means 3x cube plus sign, sorry, this minus sign 3xyz only. But y cube is 0, z cube is 0, we are differing with respect to x. So that will be 0. So this minus 3, minus 3 into y into z only, because x is 1. Differentiation of this x, 3 into xyz, 3 into yz constant. As they are, so keep them as they are. Okay, so x is 1, so that this is the differentiation. Now let me write it. This is 3x square minus 3yz divided by x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xy. Yeah, similarly, we will obtain others. What is that, sir? Let me write here similarly. Del u upon del z, or del y first. First is del y. Del u upon del y will be equal to, there will be 3y square minus 3x into z, with y will be 1. Okay, we differentiate it again with respect to y, then this y cube will be 3y square, which is this. And this 3xyz will be differentiated, y is 1, 3xz is left over. Divided by the same value, x cube plus y cube z cube minus 3xyz. This is differentiation of this value with respect to y. And del u upon del z will also be the same. That will be 3z square minus 3x into y. Because z will be 1, this 3xyz will be differentiated. And the z cube will be differentiated in case of differentiation. So in the numerator it will be 3z square, because z cube is differentiated, and this 3xyz, z is 1. The same value will be obtained, 3xy only. This is constant, divided by x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Okay, let me write them as equations. This is del u del x is, let me take second equation. This is the third one. And this is the fourth one. So adding second, third, and fourth. Adding second, third, and fourth. We obtain or we get. Okay, so we get del u upon del x, del u upon del y, del u upon del z is equal to, here we obtain 3 common in the numerator from all. Let me take 3 common. Then we will obtain x square plus y square plus z square. Their square value, that is minus sign. In the first one we will get zx. Where is this? This one yz minus zx minus xy. Okay, so this is in the numerator. Denominator will be common to all, same denominator. That will be, let me write it. What is value of this x cube by z cube minus 3xy z? This is equal to x plus y plus z in one bracket, another bracket it is x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. The same value which is in the numerator. This value is repeated. For this x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to this. This is 0 from algebra. Okay, so this value is cancelled out. So we obtain here 3 upon x plus y plus z. This is the answer we have to prove. Right in track. So this is the right in track. We have proved here. Okay. show this is first proof. So A part is solved. And let me take the B part of this. What is the B part saying? In B part we have to prove. Let me check. Okay, in the B part, what we have to prove here? In part B, okay, of 4, it says, part B of 4 is del upon del x, del upon del y, del upon del z, whole scale u. I think it is u of u is equal to minus 9 upon, we have to prove, so minus 9 upon x plus y plus z, this is whole scale, okay, whole scale. This you have to prove. So from left hand side of this, what is left hand side here? Left hand side is this, del upon del x, del upon del y, del upon del z, whole scale into u. This means this is equal to, let me write it in brackets, del upon del, del y plus del upon del z in one bracket, and the bracket will be del u, because this is whole square, this is 2 in twice, this is the same value. This when u is applied to both, this, all these three, del u upon del s, del u upon del y, del u upon del z. This can be written like this. If we multiply them, it will be same value. So now, this value we have obtained from first one, from A part. So del u upon del x plus del u upon del y plus del u upon del z equal to the 3 upon this. This is, let me write del upon del x, del y, del z, into within bracket this is 3 upon x plus y plus z. While from part A, this we have just proved from part A. This part A, we have substituted this value which we have obtained from differentiating this x time, okay, with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z. This was the result of this whole we have substituted here. Now, if I differentiate this, I mean this